Nothing to worry about. But here is the one thing. Tonight, it's a question. This one has been bothering me for a while. Why? Why is no one in the media, why is no one in the government, why is no one in this country speaking out and saying, hey, wait a minute, what's going on here? When gigantic countries like China, Russia, France, all of them are speaking out, including the UN now, and they are publicly attacking the US dollar and support dropping it as the world's currency. That's a big deal. I think the answer to why maybe is because people just don't seem to understand the consequences of what that would mean for America. Fortunately, I've been reading up on this for the last couple of years, and geez, let me try to explain it in plain English. We had World War II, and we were the victors, so we told everybody, hey, you know what we should do? We should have the gold standard, because you guys don't want to keep all that gold. It's all heavy and stuff. We'll just keep all the gold here at Fort Knox. So we put up a bunch of gold, and we promised the rest of the world that we will never, ever, ever violate the gold standard. They could just keep our dollars in their banks. Done, right? Not a problem. Well, it wasn't a problem. We got through the war and everything else. When it became a problem was in 1971 or 1972. We had been fighting Vietnam, and we decided that we also really, 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 really needed that great society. Well, we wanted everything. And what does America do? Oh, we decide we can have everything without any consequences or ramifications whatsoever. Well, the promise we made the rest of the world in 1945 and 1971 or 72, we broke. And all of a sudden the world said, wait a minute, hold it just a second. What are you doing? We said, yeah, we're going to get off that gold standard thing. I mean, it's just so 1945 for us. We'd like to print more money so we had more money to spend. Well, as you can imagine, the rest of the world was a little upset with us. But that's when we made them a second promise. Hey, guys, wait, before you dump our dollar, I tell you what. We'll just borrow a lot of money from you guys, and then we'll buy your stuff. What do you say? Well, the rest of the world, just as greedy as we were, went, okay, you'll buy our stuff? Sure. Well, we also had to promise them that we would never, ever trash our dollar. We would never spend like we were maniacs. We'd never do it. Well, now we are. You notice, when I was 45 years old, when I was growing up, this country was the world's biggest lender. But because we left the gold standard in the 1970s, we're now the world's biggest borrowers. And just like when it happens to you, if you are, really bad with a credit card, pretty soon people stop lending you money. If we can't afford something, we have borrowed the money from people to be able to buy it anyway, because we want it really bad. I mean, don't we deserve it? We work so hard. Well, now people don't want to lend to us anymore. So what do? We just go into our basement and print up some more money. Now, let me remind you, if you did that, it'd kind of be a problem. If the bank said, you know what, no loan for you, they'd throw you in jail for counterfeiting if you went down in the basement and you just spun off some more money and then went and bought that car. Why can't you do that? Because there's nothing backing your money up. Well, I got news for you. The rest of the world is finally catching on. Our country is going to pay a penalty as well because there's nothing backing our money up. After monetizing $2 trillion of debt in the last 2 weeks alone, our lenders are saying, you know, I think maybe enough here is enough. They want out. China was calling for it. Not just China, but the central bank of China was calling for an end of the dollar. Well, as Rupert Murdoch, the CEO of our parent company, recently said in a memo, and I quote, "We are in the midst of a phase of history in which nations will be redefined and their futures fundamentally altered." You can call me a suck-up because he's the big boss, man, but you know what? He's right. I couldn't agree with him more. Our future is being altered right now. It's happening right in front of our eyes. This is the period that people will write history about. And yet nobody seems to care. Nobody seems to even notice the big events. Again, I ask you the same question I started with.